iOS, iPadOS, and macOS 26 are in public beta now, so I wanted to take a look at what's new in shortcuts in these updates. This video is sponsored by Bittrex24. Let's get into it. Before we get into the new actions, I want to talk about an old action that has a new use case. The old split view actions are still here in shortcuts, but they are called split screen apps. These work with the new multitasking window system. You can open up two apps in a 50-50 view or a two-thirds, one-third view. You can set up a few of these actions in a shortcut to build out a workspace. That's pretty cool. Now, there are two issues with this action. It doesn't really support all the new tiling options in iPadOS 26, so you can't get like the three-column view or the quarters view with this action. The other thing it doesn't do is it doesn't respect the fact if you have all of your windows not covering the dock, so the dock would be always visible. If you use this action, it's going to blow them up so the dock is hidden. I really want to see Apple put in the work and update this action to support all of the new tiling options. This would be a killer way to quickly build out workspaces. So all of the new actions and shortcuts for the OS 26 updates are pretty much related to Apple Intelligence. So you will need a device that supports Apple Intelligence for these. Now, Apple Intelligence had a very rocky launch, but the actions that are in shortcuts here are actually really useful. I quite like them. The first set of actions I want to take a look at are related to writing tools. There are a set of actions focused around editing the text you write. There is proofread, rewrite, and adjust tone. These can be useful if you want to have the system double check whatever you write. If you are using a note-taking app, text editor, or an app like Drafts, you can set up a shortcut to run from the share sheet. This will take a look at the text you wrote. Then you can use one of the three actions based on what you want. Personally, I just want proofread. I don't want AI to ever rewrite the stuff that I want. I want it to just check my spelling and grammar because I'm terrible at that. This shortcut that I built here will take the text that you wrote, proofread it, and then show you an alert of how it changed the text. You can hit OK or cancel. If you hit cancel, it just stops the shortcut. But if you hit OK, it will add the text that it did the proofreading for to your clipboard so you can do whatever you want with it. I also use Drafts to write out long emails and proposals, and then I'll run it through this shortcut as well, and then I can go and paste it into my email client or wherever it needs to go. One action I've been enjoying playing with is summarize text. Now, this works with more than just text. You can run images and PDFs through it. I made a shortcut called Summarizer. This will let you send any file from the share sheet or pick a document from the Files app. It will make a summary for that document and show the results of it, and then ask you if you want to copy those results to your clipboard. Under the Summarize action, there is an option to switch the results from a summary to Create Key Points. Personally, I like the Key Points option more than Summary. It's just a bit more detail, which is good for big documents. It does a decent job of getting the major points out for things like contracts. This video is sponsored by Bittrex24. Bittrex24 is a platform that has team chat, collaboration, task and project management, and even a CRM all built into it. It's designed to optimize your workflow, save time, and enhance your efficiency. And on top of all that, it has advanced AI features built into it. Copilot serves as your assistant, giving you ideas with context, making it an excellent brainstorming partner. It can also help with ideas to generate sales or marketing ideas. It even handles call transcription and has the ability to autofill information for leads and creating task lists. Privacy and security are paramount. Copilot ensures that your data is deleted right after use. Your data doesn't get transferred anywhere, and while it's in use, it stays protected every step of the way. Bittrex24 gives you a free and secure way of using an AI assistant tool. This can help you work better with your team, manage sales, or even just deal with tasks. There are a ton of different tools built into this platform. Go check out Copilot and Bittrex24 and register for your free account today. There's two more actions for editing text. The next one is Make List from Text. I made a shortcut that lets me write out what I need when I'm going shopping. Then it adds it to my task manager's shopping list. The way this works is I start in Drafts and I just write out whatever I need. I don't need to worry about any line breaks or commas or anything like that. I just type what I need. This will work in just about any note-taking or text editor app as long as it has a share sheet or can run shortcuts. Once I have my list written, I can just run this shortcut. The AI figures out what each item is and makes a list for me. It will then add each item to my task manager. If you're using something other than Todoist, just swap in the add task action for your task manager. Set the variable to be the repeat item. Once it finishes running, it has a complete shopping list. I didn't need to do any organization, formatting. I didn't need to be worried about putting stuff in a specific order or anything like that. I just wrote what I needed and the AI took care of it for me. The last text action is make table from text. This works very similar to the last action. It will take text as an input and turn it into a table. From my testing, I found this works fine. It's not going to be able to do advanced stuff like Excel or numbers. So if you're really into that stuff and have complex tables, this won't be replacing that for you. But if you have basic inputs and you just want to see things laid out in a table, this will work great. My main issue with this action is what you're able to do with the tables after they're created. As far as I can tell, the only thing you can do is output them to an Apple Notes document. Even Numbers doesn't support them right now. Now, that being said, Numbers is not a built-in system app. That's something you have to go and download from the App Store. So it will get an update later on when iOS and iPadOS 26 actually ships. And hopefully then it gets supports for importing these tables. But right now in the beta, it does not have that, but hopefully it gets that. But right now, if you're a big Apple Notes user and you need tables or a way to generate tables for you, this is a killer action for you. Unfortunately, I am not in that Venn diagram, so I don't really have a good use case for this. Now, the real power of this shortcuts update is the use model action. This gives you option to use three different AI models with natural language text input. Plus, it both works with shortcuts variables and outputs variables as well. This means you can use it to filter, organize, look up, whatever you can think of in the middle of a shortcut. The first one I want to talk about is the local on-device model. Now, this is a fairly small model, so it can't handle complex tasks. But the benefit of it is it's completely on-device, so you don't need an internet connection and it's completely private. With this model, I've been able to get it to organize text and filter certain tasks in Todoist. Like I said, it's really meant for basic tasks. Like, I don't really have a killer complex shortcut for this. It's just kind of a filtering method or an organizing method for me. Where the real power of this action comes in is the private cloud compute model. This is Apple's cloud model that they announced last year that's all part of their private cloud compute AI system. Now, this does mean you need an internet connection to use this action, but it's able to handle a lot more complex tasks. For example, I have it adding tags to notes I add to Obsidian via a shortcut. This is how I've been doing my research this summer. But I also made another shortcut to take a look at my daily note. Now, this one requires the app Actions for Obsidian. It looks at my daily note for anything that might be a task. I tend to write a lot of what I need to do down in my daily note when I'm working in Obsidian, and I'll forget to put it in my task manager. This grabs all the tasks from my daily note and then turns them into individual tasks and adds them to Todoist. This has been super helpful for not letting small things slip through the cracks. Something else the private cloud compute model can do is do visual lookup. This means you can give it an image and ask it to describe it, great for adding alt text to images to social media posts. Or you could have it go through a few photos and filter a subject. So you can say, like, here's a bunch of photos, filter all the photos that have a dog in them. Now, this doesn't just work with images. You can also pass documents to it as well. It will go through the contents of it. This can be helpful to find specific information or even compare two documents looking for the differences. Now, full credit, my pal Federico Vitici, he's the one that figured out that the private cloud compute model is the only one that supports visual lookup. The on-device model does not support that. So full credit to Federico. The last model is ChatGPT. If the other two previous models didn't work for you, there's a good chance the ChatGPT model will be able to handle what you want. Now, I say good chance because it is running an older model. It's running GPT-4, not 4.0, just 4. But if you're looking for something to filter or organize a bunch of text, like a lot of text, this will do that. Personally, for me, I always start with the private cloud compute model. But if that can't handle it for some reason, I will try the ChatGPT option. If it's something that's really built into Shortcuts, that's fine. I'll stick with ChatGPT, the use model, and ChatGPT Shortcuts. But what I've been kind of finding is if I realize I need something more complex than private cloud compute, I'll usually just go to the ChatGPT app because I have all my projects and history there. It has the latest model, so I'm going to be getting the best possible performance. I just feel like I'm getting better results out of that than ChatGPT in the use model action. So that's it. That's what I've been doing with Shortcuts in the new OS 26 updates. If you've been doing anything interesting, let me know in the comments below. I'm always, you know, love talking Shortcuts with people. So I always want to hear what you all are doing with Shortcuts. My thanks to Bittrex24 for sponsoring this video. If you liked the video, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe if you haven't already, and have a great day.